Hi guys, welcome to Linux Hi YouTube channel. My name is Ram Mishra and I'm your online instructor. So what's in this video? In this video I will tell you how to work with Linux chat services in RHEL 8. So guys, let's begin the topic. But before start the last session, we have to understand a few points, which is which command we use as a chat or messenger services in Linux. So guys, for the demonstration purpose, I have a lab scenario for you. Please look at that. Guys, this is my Linux chat server lab setup environment. So let's start with the introduction of few important command which is used as a form of Linux messenger services, or we can say chat services. Okay, so the first command is vol command. So vol command is what? Basically vol command write a message to all user, and it display a message on the terminal of all currently logged in users. This is a kind of one to all broadcast communication message channel. Second one is the write command. Write command send a message to another user. This is a kind of one-to-one communication message channel. And third and very important command is NC command, netcat command. This is a feature packed networking utility which reads and write data across the network from command line utility. Okay, so here I have a two trusted virtual machine. First machine acting as a Linux server with the hostname server1.example.com with the IP address of 192.168.0.1 and running Linux OS is RHEL 8.0. So I will configure this machine as my chat server or messenger server, you can say that. And second machine is Linux acting as a Linux client machine with the hostname is station1.example.com, IP address is 192.168.0.2 and current running OS is RHEL 8.0. Okay, so what I'm going to demonstrate you in this chat server, I'm talking about this one. In this chat server, I make few user and login through locally as well as network login and try to execute all three commands and grab the respective results. Okay, so let's begin the lab session. So I minimize this console and open my trusted Linux virtual machine. Here is my first machine and this is my another machine. Okay, so guys, this is my Linux terminal and currently I am on my server side. This is a server and this is a client one. Okay, so firstly I will show you the host name and the IP address and running Linux version of this machine. So I log in with root account first, give the password. My host name is of this machine is server1.example.com and currently I am using the IP address is 192.168.1 and Red Hat release version is 8.0. Okay, so we have to follow few steps to work with Linux messenger services, or we can say chat services. So the first step is to make some normal user on server side. So for this I go with the user add command for make users, and for assign the password of those user I use passwd command. Okay, so I start with user add command. I say user add and first user is user test1, could be anything, and I make one more user test2. Okay, and give the password. So I run the passwd command test1, password is 1212, small password, again with for test2 1212. Great, and let's verify the identification of this user with the id command. So I run the command id test1. Okay, it's created, and test2, okay, it shows uid, gid and groups. Okay, so we have successfully completed this step. Now move to the next one, which is start demonstration with all three commands one by one. Okay, so now on the server side I log in as a root user, and for access test one user account I log in from my client side using SSH command. Okay, so for this I go to the client machine and log in with root user first. So I log in with root, give the password, and first of all I show the host name. This is a client, that is station1.example.com. Red Hat release version is 8.0 and IP address is 192.168.0.2. Okay, now from here I run the SSH command to access test one user console of server machine. So how can I do that? I say SSH test one at the rate server1.example.com, ask for confirmation, say yes, and give the password, that is 12. Okay, I log in. So if I go with logname command, look at that is test1 and currently I am on server1.example.com. okay, so now let's see move to the our first command, which is vol command. So let's see what happened when I run the vol command from root user on the server side. So I back on my root machine, that is root address server1, and here I run the command vol. So I press enter and now I'm going to type some message. So what I'm saying, this is inform to all of you, could be nice, anyone message, we have urgent meeting at 5 p.m. Okay, now see what happened when I press enter. I press enter and I run control D. I press going to control D. Look at that. See, I got the broadcast message from root@servant.example.com. Look at that here. So this is a kind of broadcast message from root user to all logged user on servant.example.com. This is informed to all of you. We have urgent meeting at 5 p.m. Okay guys, so this is the first example of wall command. Now move to the next command, which is write command. Suppose if we want to start the chat session between two user, not with the all user, then we can use write command. So let's see what happened when I run write command from test two user on server side. So firstly, what I have to do, firstly let me clear the screen first. Press Ctrl C, okay, and clear screen. Okay, now I log in as a test2 user on server side. So I say exist and log in with test2, password 12. I log in successfully. Okay, now start with chat session with the help of write command. So I say write and username is test1. Okay, so here I have to mention the username with whom I want to start the chat session. So see, when I press enter, what happened? Look at that. On the another side, on this machine, on the, my client machine, you can say I got the chat window open for the test1 account. So whatever I type from here from my test2 user, it will shown on the test1 account. So I'll show you. Here I am and say hi, how are you? Press enter. See, I got the message. Now if test1 user, this user want to reply to this chat session, he has to also use write command and open the session for the test2 account. So press enter here and again he says write test2. Okay, press enter. Now look at that, chat window open for test1 account also. Now on the both side chat window open and they can start chat session. So let's see practical. So here I am and I said thanks for this. I press enter. I got the message here. Again I am on the client side. I say okay, nice to see you. Press enter. I got the message here. Okay, so this way I can start chat between two users on the same machine. If you want to quit from there, simple, use control C, and on the same side use control C. Now in the both case, either I talk about the wall command or I talk about the write command, I use the same machine with the different account. But suppose I want to chat with the different machine with different account, then how it is possible? So for this type of scenario, we use our last command, that is NC command, that is very, very important. So let's start the chat session with different account on the different machine. So first of all, I quit from all accounts, quit from there, and let's say quit, exist. Okay, so this is my default condition. So on the server side, I log in as a root user, and on the client side, I make a new account. So on server side, I log in with root first. Okay, and on the client side, that is station one, I log in with root and make any new user, user, I'd say Google, and give the password, say 1212, great. Exit from there and log in with Google 12, great. Okay, now I want to start a chat session on both these different machine with different account. So on the server side, I'm going to run the NC command. So here I am on the root address servant.example.com. I run the command NC-L-P and any random port. So NC means netcat command, L for listening, P for local port, or you can say any random port. So I give any random number, that is 9999. You can go with 12345, anyone. That is a random number. Okay, and press enter. So, and press enter. Let's see what happened. This is this will start my chat server session. So my chat server session is started. So on the client side, to join this session, I have to run the command. Here I am on the client side, Google side. I say NC and the IP address of the server. So 192.168.0.1 and the port random port number, that is 19999. Okay, when I press enter, see what happened. Now session established on the both side, we can start the chat. So and we can start it. So let's try to check it. Hi, look at that. Here is hello. Again, I'm fine. Press enter. Okay, so thus we can easily communicate with both machine with different accounts. So this is the process through which you can communicate and assign the chat session. And if you want to stop this process or you want to quit from there, you can simply press Control C. So I'm going to press Control C here, say exist. And similarly, if you want to quit from there, you can use Control C and type exist. So guys, this is how we can work with the Linux chat, or you can say messenger services, in RHEL 8. And finally, this is the end of this topic. Hopefully you enjoyed and learned new things. Soon I will come up with another new interesting topic. Till then, keep practicing. If you feel something I have missed or you wanted to know more something else, please leave your comment and subscribe my YouTube channel for more updates. If you like this video, please do not forget to like, share and subscribe my channel and press the bell icon button for the latest update. Thanks for watching. Stay safe and goodbye.